Being in SAPL, you find yourself making decisions on a daily basis, and it actually sharpens your mentality as a leader, not just in the organization, also within the community. You find out that everyone around you wants you to basically make those decisions for them. So your job as a police officer prepares you for this, and that's one good thing about SAPL. So it builds great leaders in us.
Leadership is getting the most out of people, I guess, and also empowering people, not just with the job, but with everything that they're dealing with in their life.
I think everyone in SAPL is seen as a leader. You don't just have to put the uniform on for people to believe that you are a leader. I think when people say you work for SAPL, people have an expectation that you are part of a very professional organisation, and therefore what you do and how you do it in the best way possible.
I think showing leadership within the community is about setting an example for others to follow. And I do that by performing my role to the best of my ability to support other areas of SAPL, but also by communicating with members of the public that I do come in contact with to provide that support and reassurance.
Look, leadership often is thought about in terms of rank, but it's in the case of policing, every police officer is a leader in the community. It doesn't matter whether you're a probationary constable or the commissioner, everyone has a role in providing leadership, because when the public are in trouble and they want help and that police officer turns up at the front door, they don't care whether it's a male or female, what race or nationality they are, they just want help. And that leadership in the community is what's important. So I don't think it's necessarily about rank, although that's very important to us in this organisation. It's about the sort of person you are and the style in which you lead in the community.
We're all leaders, right from your home. If you have younger ones, you have older ones, you have parents, you've got children. One way or the other, you have to show a sense of leadership. You take charge of the most things that you do. You find yourself in a situation, walking down the street, and you know, you see something wrong, you actually take a decision, make that decision to do something about it. That's called leadership. It doesn't necessarily mean, you know, you have to be the head of, you know, department, or, but in the little of things that you do in your everyday life.
There are obviously formalised pathways for people to take on those leadership or management roles. But I think if you have that natural belief in yourself and are determined with a little bit of resilience, then you can absolutely achieve anything that you want to.